Chilean, I love those kind of phrases.
Oh.
Can you? Yeah, it's nice. I was taking some notes, but I could be tweeting all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, there are big good slogans. So, what do you think is the most important? What do you think is the most important thing? The most important thing that can learn to students?
It's an interesting question because we're trying to balance out learning for that we're supposed to do in terms of hitting standards and making sure the kids can do well on their test. Us as teachers are trying to figure out how to balance that out with what the kids themselves want to learn. So my advice actually would be not what is the one lesson that kids need that I could teach them, but what is it that I could teach teachers about what they need? And for that, it's really to follow the lead of the kids. Let the kids use the technology how they want to use it instead of how the teacher thinks that they should use it. Because when we think about smart cities, it's not about ICT. It's about using the cell phone in the classroom the same way that the kids use the mobile in their day-to-day lives. That's really what's most powerful to them, is to figure out how to take a tool that they use all day, every day, to learn and to communicate and use that for learning in the classroom, and not to cut off the use of the mobile phone or the tablet in the classroom.
And the scientists have made the connection. That school and that university are linked up in a way that hadn't existed before. So all of a sudden, the kids can walk down the street and
it may seem interesting idea that was about around values.
Mm-hmm.
The majority of the projects that you have commented, the majority of activities that you do, you actually do are plenty of values,
mm-hmm.
of the learning of values for them.
Right.
And you said that it's not, that it's very difficult to know how to teach sciences.
Right.
And I think it's definitely so much difficult to learn how to teach values.
Right.
So, how do you please comment a bit more the relationship between values and the smart cities and your
kids? Right. Kids have different values educationally than we as policymakers or politicians have. Kids don't value doing well in a test. Kids don't value knowledge for knowledge's sake. Kids have values, things like making their community a better place, making the world a better place, having meaningful interactions with people who are older and younger than them. So kids have the exact type of values that we want them to have to be excellent citizens in the world. They just simply don't value gaining knowledge for knowledge's sake. That doesn't mean anything to them. So our job as teachers is to figure out how to take those values, community, improving the world, they're caring for family, they're caring for others, and use the technology to allow them to express that in a way that's acceptable to us as teachers. And the challenge to us is that if every single person in the classroom came up with their own project and carried it through, it's a huge project for a teacher. That's 10 minutes every day with each student, and we just simply don't have that much time. So it's up to us as teachers to figure out how to best facilitate those types of projects in the classroom. And often that means giving kids the opportunity to choose what they want to do, but also choose how to do it and structure it in a way that is manageable for us as teachers. But we shouldn't worry about kids today. We shouldn't worry about their values. Their values are absolutely in the right place. We just need to make sure that our goals and our values in the classroom are aligned with their goals and their values.
They had never gone to college before. To say, whoa, this is what college is like. This is what college students look like. This is what a laboratory looks like. So the connection, once it's made and facilitated,
that I describe is for primary school students. And what the research shows us is that primary school students don't need to learn facts. They don't need to learn formulas. What they need is passion and interest and excitement and engagement. They need to see science as something like curing cancer or figuring out how to help someone who has a disease walk again. It needs to be something real to them. And so we don't, It's different. It's different than what high school kids need. High school kids need the facts and the figures. But we just really need to show the kids that science is fun and wonderful. And the best people to do that are the scientists themselves. Because they didn't get into science because they love to memorize facts and formulas. They got into science because they want to cure cancer or they want to design prosthetic limbs. And so we need to help scientists to communicate that in a way that their enthusiasm comes through. I mean, I have people who study the most boring things ever. I mean, they study incredibly boring things. But when they talk about their work, their passion and their love comes through. And that's what kids need to be exposed to at that particular age group. They really need to see that science is something that people do and not something that is just done in a laboratory someplace by this sort of stereotypical mad scientist character.